who wrote this song. This song is the greatest song since Happy Birthday. I don't care what anyone says. And this is my good friend, Franke Previte. Notice how I bring you in as the music changes? Doesn't that sound just so well planned? How you doing, pal?
Oh, happy birthday to you.
Come on, man. That song, every wedding, you can't escape that song if your life depended on it. It's one of the greatest songs ever made.
Well, how much do I owe you for saying?
So, have you been contacted about the remake?
You know what? I know about as much about it as you do. I found out by a friend of mine calling me up and going, can you believe that they're going to make a movie, Dirty Dancing? I go, well, I knew they were going to do that a couple of years ago.
Right.
But I didn't think it would be an ABC movie. I thought it was going to be in the movie.
Oh, okay.
And so it ends up that it's just going to be like a one-time ABC, you know, movie for television.
Well, look at the last one time. The last one time is still alive, right?
Well, it blows my mind. You know, it is beyond what any comprehension I could ever think, you know, a movie could run and a song could run. And, you know, it's really a combination of the power of Patrick Swayze and that song and Jennifer Warren and what it's done to our culture.
Yeah, absolutely. Franke, tell the story how you wrote this. On a New Jersey, on the Garden State Parkway, tell the story how this song comes into your head.
Well, actually, I got a call from Jimmy Einer, who was the president of Millennium Records, a label that Franke and the Knockouts, which is a band I was in back in the 80s, and he had decided that he was going to close up shop and go into movies. So 2 years later, he calls me out of the blue, and here I am. I'm writing songs, trying to get another record deal. And by the way, one of the songs that I wrote trying to get this record deal was Hungry Eyes. It was another song that I wrote for the movie.
Fancy that.
So he calls me and says, hey, Franke, I got this little song, this little movie I want you to write a song for. My answer to him was, Jimmy, I'm too busy. I'm trying to get a deal. He goes, no, man, I've got a great feeling about this movie. I think you should write a song. I go, I'm telling you the truth, Jimmy, I'm too busy. Uh-huh. Make time. This is going to change your life. And I go, well, you did that 2 years ago when you shut your label. So he goes, Franke, I'm telling you, I got a good feeling. So I called the guy I was writing with at the time, John DiNicola, and he sent me a track. And I, you know, on the way to the studio, I'm on the Garden State Parkway, exit 140. And as a songwriter, everybody writes their songs in their own way. And mine was, how I write songs is I listen to music because I'm not a player. I'm a singer and a lyricist. So he sent me the track, and I'm jamming in the car going, what the hell am I singing? You know. So I'm scribbling on an envelope. I had the time of my life on an envelope, and that's where the song was created.
How about that?
I guess so.
How about that? And you wrote the only duet, right?
Well, out of the 150 songs that were submitted for that scene, Time of My Life was the only duet. And so when I met Patrick Swayze at the Academy Awards, you know, he was all, you know, very excited to meet me. And I'm like, what's up? And he goes, you have no idea. You have no idea what that song did for this movie. We hated it. This movie. We didn't have a song. We had rehearsed that last scene to a Lionel Richie track. Good song, but it wasn't an original for the movie. Uh-huh. And he said, you know, we were just like, let's get it over with. And then somebody walks in and goes, we got one more cassette, 150 cassette. You know, so we filmed that day to you singing with that girl. I said, yeah, Rochelle Capel.
Nice.
He goes, at the end of the day, we were like, holy cow, what happened? Let's go make this movie.
And then that movie and that song, right? The movie, the video, the DVD, the CD, the concerts, right? The Dirty Dancing tours.
Yeah.
Every wedding, every affair you go to, you cannot escape it.
No, nobody, not RCA, not Vestron Films, thought anything of that movie, even after Time of My Life was in it. Uh-huh. When the movie came out, they didn't even have a record. They, meaning RCA, didn't have a record press. by the time the first week, they were going to put it out for 1 week and send it to DVD. And by the end of 1 week, 300,000 records were back ordered. Before RCA could print a record, there were a million records back ordered, and it ended up selling 50 million records.
Now, as great as the song is, and of course, Hungry Eyes. I mean, Hungry, if you hadn't written Time of My Life, Hungry Eyes would be talking about in the same vein, because that was huge. But have you ever felt the pressure? I saw Eddie and the Cruisers too. Have you ever felt the pressure to try to top it?